Welcome you all to Variables and Tokens in Python. Let's move forward. So today's agenda is, what are tokens and variables? We will talk about these tokens and variables here, and we will talk about the elements of the tokens one by one. Let's move forward. So let's read about tokens. Tokens are the smallest individual element of a program. Everything you see inside a program is a token. Like you can say that individual words and the punctuation marks, these all are the tokens. So let's move forward. There are generally five types of tokens we have. So first is a keyword, or you can say reserve words. Okay, so keywords are the special reserve words, like whose meaning is already defined in the program. Okay, programming language. We cannot use keywords for any other purpose inside the programming. Every programming language have some set of keywords. So you can see here, I just have written here some set of keywords over here. You cannot use them as an variables, as an identifiers. They are some, you know, they have a special meaning, as I told you, and they are the reserved one. Okay, so let's move forward and let's talk about now identifiers. Identifier is a user-defined name given to a part of a program. They are not reserved. Okay, either name given to a variable or a function or any programming element. So there are some basic naming conventions that are listed below. So let's talk about it. Identifier is an arbitrarily long sequence of letters and digits. Okay, they can contain alphabets A to Z, small letters, capital letters, and they can use the digits also. And it is a case sensitive. They are like upper and lower case letters are different counted. Like if I have written here cat like this way, and in the next line I am writing like this way, so they will create a different meaning over there in the programming. Okay, they will have a different meaning. So identifiers must not contain any special character except underscore. So we can use only underscore. Okay, and no extra special symbols can be used here. Okay, so they are unlimited in length. You can say that they must not be the keyword of the Python. Fine. So next, move forward about the literals. Literals are constant values. They are the constant values, or you can say they have a fixed values. Okay, for performing various operations and calculations. Okay, like they have fixed values. They can be numeric and they can be non-numeric values. Numeric like 404 and non-numeric like D. Like here I have written a string in the double quotes like RAM. Okay, so I have written it in a double quote, so it is a string here. Okay, so in Python one can form string literals by enclosing text in both forms of quotes, like in single quote also, and you can just enclose it in the double quotes also. Fine. So there are just three types of literals. Okay, integer literals, floating point literals, as I have given the examples here. So they are the integer one, they are the floating one, and they are the character literals, as I have given you the example here. Fine. So you can say single characters are enclosed in a single quote, and while sequence of characters are enclosed in the double quotes. Like single quote, we can write here single character A. Okay, and we can write here slash n, like, and if I have to write down just a sequence, as I have written here a RAM, you can say that. If I am writing here hello, so what I will write here double quotes. Okay, this is what I just mean to say here. Okay, so next are the operators. Operators are the tokens that trigger some that triggers some type of computation or the calculation or the action. Okay, they just perform the logical and arithmetical operations. Fine. So various programming languages provide various set of operations, like here I have defined, here I have given the example also. So next is the delimiters. Delimiters are also known as, you can say them, separators. Okay, they act as a separators. Okay, they separate the, they just separate the values, or to enclose some values. Like I have given example here, they are the brackets. So we have the different types of brackets here. Okay, so we call them delimiters also and the separators also. Okay, so next is, so let's talk about variable. Variables, as the name says, the value is not fixed here. It varies. Okay, it varies. The values that can be used and processed during the program run, and we don't need to declare the variables before using them or declare their type. A variable is created the moment we first assign a value to it. Okay, like I have written here, age is equal to 16. Fine, this value is assigned to the variable age through this equal sign. Okay, through this equal sign. Okay, fine. So let's see one more example here. I have written message. I'm just writing here, the message is equal to WhatsApp docs, n is equal to 17 and pi is equal to 3.174. now, the at the moment I have just assigned this value to the message variable, it is created. Okay, 17 is the value is assigned to n and this value is assigned to pi. Okay, in my window, when I will write down print message, then it will display that WhatsApp doctor. Okay, next if I will write here print n, okay, then it will say it will 17, and if I'll write here print pi, then it will write here 3.14159. okay, this is how variable works. See, and in this I just told you, this is my string. Okay, and this is my integer value and this is my floating point value. Okay, so I just told you three types of values here. Fine. Next is the, we have some few rules here. Okay, few rules for creating the variables in Python are same as they are in high level languages, like they are case sensitive. If I'm writing age and I'm writing it in the capital letter, they are treated as two different variable names. Okay, they are treated as two different variable, means it is a case sensitive language. And as I told you, keywords or words which are having the special meaning should not be used as a variable name. Variable should be short and meaningful. Okay, and all the variable names must begin with a letter or an underscore. No extra special symbols should be used except my underscore. Okay, so before starting letter, variable name may contain letters, digits and underscore, but no spaces or special characters are allowed here. Okay, so this is how, these are the special rules that we have to follow. Okay, like a variable name cannot start with number, it can only contain the alpha numeric characters, underscores, and they are case sensitive, and reserve words cannot be used naming the variable. Clear? So all these are the rules. Next is, we have examples here, valid variables and invalid variables. Like I told you that I have age, these all are the variable one. Okay, and these on the down one, they are the invalid variable names. Why? Because here I am using the minus sign and here I am using the special symbol, it is starting with the number. Okay, so they are the valid, there are few examples what are valid and invalid variables. Next is how to assign the values to our variables. Okay, how we can assign it. So we can assign the values, we can assign the values through the operator. Okay, that is known as assignment operator, is equal to sign. Okay, so I have a here example. If I am writing here student is equal to Archit, that means the variable will be created at that moment only, and the student variable has to hold student's name. Here I have defined the integer value to age, so variable age to hold student's age here. Okay, as I told earlier also, we don't need to declare the variables with any data type, with any particular type, and can even change type even after they have been set. So we have integer, floating and string. I have given the example earlier also for this. Next is the memory representation. How the variable is stored, okay, and how the memory address has been assigned to it. In Python, variable act as a pointer and tied to some value. Okay, let's have example. I have the three examples with me. Okay, first is, if I am writing here a is equal to 10, at that time this value has been assigned a memory address 11256. Okay, memory address 11256, clear? Means now here what is happening, the memory address is assigned to the value, not to the variable. Okay, here in Python, memory address is assigned to the value, not to the variable. Okay, if next time I am writing here b is equal to 10, that means I already have the value 10, okay, in my Python. Okay, so what will happen, it will give the same address to 10 value. It will not give the new memory address to variable b. So please remember, memory address is assigned according to the value, not according to the variable. Okay, not according to the variable. So let's see the example 2 now. If I am writing here, now I am changing the values. If I am writing here a is equal to 20, I am giving this, and on the other side I am writing here y is equal to a, but a is 20 here. Okay, so what will happen, again this memory address will be assigned to 20. Values are same, but no worries if variable is different here. Okay, if variable is different here. So let's move forward. Okay, here is another example. Now here variables are same, but values are different. So I'm repeating again, memory address is assigned according to the values, not according to the variable. Okay, so now here I am having a is equal to 10. Next time if I am writing here a is equal to 20, that means this memory address, the new memory address will be assigned to it. Okay, new memory address will be assigned to 20, clear? So that means here this variable, this value will become useless. Why useless? Because here this is, it is not having any reference. Okay, this value is not having any reference, so there it is unreferenced. Okay, you can say useless, and it will be collected by the garbage collector of the Python. Okay, so the new value will be 20. Like you know, we can give one example also, like we as a, if the, to the kids we give the toy, and the boy is playing with the old toy, and suddenly we are just giving him a new toy, then what will happen? He will just throw out the new toy, old one toy, and he will start playing with the new one. Okay, so that the old one toy for that kid becomes like a, you know, useless. He will not look at all at that toy. Okay, so same here, that it will become the useless, and a variable, it will become unreferenced because it is not having any reference here. So this happens here. This is how the memory representation goes on. Okay, so next is multiple assignments, means how we can assign the value, single value, to several variables. okay? Like first is assigning the same value to multiple variables. I am writing here A is equal to B is equal to C is equal to 12. This means that 12, A value is also 12, B's value is also 12 and C's value is also 12. Okay, fine. Next is assigning multiple values to multiple variables. Okay, like I don't want to give the same value to each variable. So what I'll write here, this is how I will write here, and respectively the values will be assigned to the variables. This is how we can assign a single value to several variables So L values and R values. L values that come on the left hand side of an assignment. So L values are always variables. R values that come on the right hand side of an assignment. Okay, as we can see here, the variables always come on the left hand side. Okay, but we cannot say that 20 is equal to A and 30 is equal to B. Okay, so there will be an error. Okay, we will have an error. So L values are the objects, that come on the left hand side or right hand side of an assignment statement. Okay, so L values can come on left or right hand side, but the R values can come on right hand side of an assignment statement only. So this thing we should have to keep in mind, okay, when we are just talking about L values and R values. I hope you have understood the tutorial, and if you like my video, kindly like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.